Dear students, welcome back to Full Scholarships live video series. Today we'll be discussing about the fully funded scholarships at the Mohamed Bin Zayed University of Artificial Intelligence, MBZUAI. In UAE, we'll show you the full process for this particular university, how do you apply for this particular scholarship, and it's open to postgraduate studies like Masters and PhD. There are also undergraduate courses, but they are not covered at the moment for the scholarship, but right now Masters and PhD scholarships are open, so you can apply for this. Before that, let me remind you to subscribe to YouTube channel Full Scholarships and do follow us on Instagram page as well. The link for this Mohamed Bin Zayed University scholarship is given in the video description below. You can check out any of the videos, links are in the respective description of each of the videos. Also, in the about section of the YouTube, you can see all the links are posted there. Also, you can check out Instagram stories, and on Instagram you can directly message us and ask for the link, or you can directly visit our website fullscholarships.net or cashnook.com, and you can apply for these particular scholarship. Now, once you are on our website, you can read about this particular scholarship in UAE. So here are some brief details. So your host country is UAE, and the host university is Mohamed Bin Zayed University of Artificial Intelligence. And degree level that you can complete is the Masters and PhD. Financial benefit, it's a fully funded opportunity. And the first deadline, priority deadline, is the November 15th. And late deadline is the December 15th. We have already premiered this video previously. If you already applied, you can directly apply for new scholarships. But if you have previously just saved as a draft, right now you have the last opportunity to submit this particular opportunity. So 100% free tuition will be there on campus, accommodation, health insurance, monthly stipend for MSc will be 15,500 dirhams, and a PhD it will be 18,500 dirhams. And if you are dependent with them, you have married, you are married scholar, and you will be receiving the allowances of around additional 7,500 dirhams. And UAE nationals will be receiving the stipend of 37,500, and PhD scholars will be receiving 43,500 dirhams. Then who is eligible? So it should be from one of the STEM programs, computer science, engineering, mathematics, physics. Previously you should have one of these and have GPA of 3.2 or 4 on a scale. And then if you have IELTS and TOEFL, that's well and enough. For PhD, minimum 3.2 GPA is required. Documents is online application form, CV, passport, copy, photograph. And if you are a national from any of the other countries, you can submit national IDs. And for UAE nationals, these documents are required. For local residents, only these Emirate ID is required. How do you apply for this particular opportunity? You can scroll down. At the end of the application, you can see click here to apply is given here. So click on this link here and you can see the requirements for this particular opportunity is here. Get graduate admissions page, all these scholarship details are here, MSc programs, PhD programs, and Masters in Applied Artificial Intelligence program is also mentioned here. Important dates, everything is given here, you can see. Now at the end, you can see, if you scroll, you can see ready to start your new education journey. Click on apply now button here. So once you click on that apply now button, it will take you to the application portal here. For the first time users, you have to sign up. And once you sign up, this type of dashboard will be there. And now you can simply start your application. Click on apply now here. And you can view programs for undergraduate, graduate, or postgraduate. But right now you can click on graduate programs. Click on this and start the master's program. Click on master's program here. After you click on master's program, you can see different programs are there. And you can view all other programs also. And you can see deadlines for the program are also given here. This is the priority deadline, 15th of November 2025. And by 15th of December, this is the final submission deadline. For example, you have chosen any of the program, you can click on this program and you can see. Now, once you click on this program, it will be added to your applications, you can see. And after that, you have to complete your personal details. And once you complete your personal details, then your preferred faculty member from the university, then academic history from the university, you have previously completed employment history, qualifications, awards you have, and then the referee recommendations, review and confirm. So you have this form. I have like previously submitted one of the forms here. I'll again submit one form. I'll show you the process here. You can click on view program, master's program. You can apply for other programs as well. You can see. So as you see that I am able to only apply one program at a time. So that's the reason it's not showing apply option to me. But if you wish to apply, you can apply for the programs that are listed here. You can see everything is there. And particular scholarships are also listed here, you can see. So you have to complete whole of the process through this portal here. And like this, you have the personal details, your preferred faculty details, that if you are going for PhD then, and for masters by research, you have to enter the faculty details here. So you have to contact them by email, ask them that I am going to apply for this particular scholarship here, and I need your consent so that I can submit the application. Then if you have your academic history, like previously you have done your bachelor's, obviously for master's there's a requirement of bachelor's degree. It should be from one of the STEM programs. You should have physics, chemistry, maths or any of them in that, and you have to mention this program here. And after that you have to submit the employment history. If you have employment history, you can submit that as well. And then the qualifications, like optional qualifications, if you have any additional qualifications, like your diploma or you have any courses, you have any workshops, you can submit that as well. Then the awards and publications, if you have achievements, if you have any gold medalists previously, or if you have any research papers published already, if you have any international conferences, national conferences, whatever is the participation you have done, you can submit and list them here. After that, referee recommendations. This is the important part. So previously you have completed your bachelor's degree, and there you have to get the reference letters from your previous professors or previous faculty members so that you can submit them here. So there's a particular form that you have to fill, the email address of the form, designation of the person that who is giving you the reference, you have to submit them. Then you have to review all the information that you submitted, and then you can simply confirm and submit the application. In the documents, you have to upload your resume, your CV, and the bachelor's degree certificate, and the transcripts, also the enrollment letter. Besides this, you have to submit the bachelor's degree transcripts, then a photograph with a white background, then proof of the English proficiency language. If your IELTS, TOEFL, you can submit them, and or you have to submit English medium of instruction letter, and then statement of purpose, you have to submit that here. And then valid passport. All these documents must be in the PDF format. If you have additional files, you can submit them, like achievements or gold medalists. You have anything in addition to submit, you can submit them. Then ref recommendation letters, like this, you have the form here. You have to enter the organization name, job position of the professor, salutation, the first name, last name, and the email of the professor. And after that, you have to send them the request. So I have submitted two requests to the professors, and then the status is still pending. Once they submit my recommendation letter, it will be completed. After you complete this, you have to click on submit task here. So that's how you submit this recommendation form, referee form. And your referee should receive an email. He should be completing this before the deadline, that is the 15th of December or 15th of November, whichever is earlier for him. So you should submit them. Also, you can check out undergrad internship programs. There are a lot of programs available. You can see research internship program is there, and you can submit to these as well. And if you wish to go for the doctorate programs, you can submit them as well. You can see doctorate programs are also listed here. You can apply to the doctorate programs. So as per this eligibility right now, I have already completed the forms here, so I won't be able to submit second application. That's it. If you wish to go for this video that I have previously published, you can check out that here. So previously we have had that here. So you should follow the same steps in the video so that you can apply for this particular opportunity. So if you find it, you can easily check out that we had previously submitted the application, so definitely it will be there. So you should check out our previous videos, follow the steps and apply for this particular scholarship in the Middle East, UAE, and it's a fully funded scholarship. In that scholarship, in that application form, they'll be asking you regarding the scholarship or the funding details that you have to submit. So kindly follow us on Instagram page and follow us on the YouTube. You can subscribe there and keep checking our website fullscholarships.net or cashmanook.com. All the information is published there, premiered there. Before publishing, we verify, and do share with your friends who wish to go for the Middle East UAE for studies. So this video will be very beneficial for them. Do subscribe. I'm signing off for today. Have a nice day ahead.